He who dwells in the shelter of the Most High will abide in the shadow of the Almighty. I will say to the Lord, my refuge and my fortress, my God in whom I trust. For he will deliver you from the snare of the fowler and from the deadly pestilence. He will cover you with his pinions, and under his wings you will find refuge. His faithfulness is a shield and a buckler. You will not fear the terror of the night, nor the arrow that flies by day, nor the pestilence that stalks in the darkness, nor the destruction that wastes at noonday. 1,000 may fall at your side, 10,000 at your right hand, but it will not come near you. You will only look with your eyes and see the recompense of the wicked. Because you have made the Lord your dwelling place, the Most High, who is my refuge, no evil shall be allowed to befall you. No plague come near your tent. For he will command his angels concerning you to guard you in all your ways. On their hands they will bear you up, lest you strike your foot against the stone. You will tread on the lion and the adder. The young lion and the serpent you will trample underfoot. Because he holds fast to me in love, I will deliver him. I will protect him, because he knows my name. When he calls to me, I will answer him. I will be with him in trouble. I will rescue him and honor him. With long life, I will satisfy him and show him my salvation.
Worship the Lord with gladness. Come before Him with joyful songs. And know that the Lord is God. And we are His people, the sheep of His pasture. Amen? Enter His gates with thanksgiving and His courts with praise. Give thanks to Him and praise His name. Hallelujah! For the Lord is good and His love endures forever. His faithfulness continues to all generations. Amen? God is good and all the time. God is good all the time. He put a song of praise in this heart of mine. God is all the time.
And I heard feedback. Kuya Miguel is fixing the mic for me. Continue to praise and glorify the Lord in our midst. You know, He's just so good, so good, so wonderful, so glorious that we can go ahead and attribute the goodness of God in our lives, and we have no fear, absolutely no fear in all things that are going on, regardless of how immediate and how sudden they could be. We are still standing indeed by the grace of God. And today, folks, we just want to remember the manifest grace of God, made known only by the only begotten Son of God, no less than the Lord Jesus Christ Himself. And this is what we celebrate today, because if it not for this finished work of His, all of this would be nothing. Today, O Lord Jesus Christ, we want to remember the body that You gave for all of us. You did not hesitate. You did not hold back. Instead, You laid down Your life in all of its fullness. You stepped out of Your glory. You were born as one of us. And even as You walked this earth, You went ahead and thought with every day of Your existence and every breath that You took here in this lifetime, You were thinking, one of these days, I will and I am willing and able to lay down my life for all of these people. Today we want to remember that, O Lord Jesus Christ. We remember, in spite of all the anxiety, in spite of all the physical pain, in spite of all the mental torment, in spite of all the social persecution we may be going through right now, we remember You, O Lord Jesus Christ, and we thank You that You did not hold back, and we can have peace in all understanding, beyond all understanding, because of Your finished work, because of the body that You've given us. So we receive peace right now in Jesus' name. Amen. Let's go ahead and eat. And we thank You, Jesus. We thank You because You did not stop at saving us. You did not stop at laying down Your life, but You also shed Your blood. If it was the blood of a bull and goat, it would be the forgiveness of our sins for a season. But we praise the Lord Jesus Christ because He chose to shed His blood, no less than the blood of the Lamb of God who took away all the sins, and all of our sins can guarantee that we have not just been forgiven now, but forever. Because of the blood of the Lord Jesus Christ, our sins have not been taken away from us for a season, but no, it has been totally and fully separated from us as the East is from the West. For this, O Lord Jesus Christ, in spite of all the mistakes that we commit, in spite of all the habits we are struggling against, we give You glory and we give You thanks, O Lord Jesus Christ, that by the finished work and by Your blood that You have shed, we can have peace, that You will never, never leave us nor forsake us. Thank You, Jesus. Thank You, Father. Thank You, Holy Spirit. Let's go ahead and drink. Glory and honor to His name. Glory and honor to His name. Folks, let's go ahead and just continue to worship the Lord in this place. Let's go ahead and continue to give Him thanks because He is worthy of all the praise.
Hallelujah. Praise Jesus. Thank You, Lord. I will give thanks to You, Jesus, the author of our life. We fix our eyes on You, Jesus, the author and the finisher of our faith. And we give thanks to You for everything, O God. And we give thanks to You, O God. We give You all the glory. We give You all the honor. We give You all the praise, O God. Thank You, Jesus. Oh, praise Jesus. Come on, let you sing this song with all our heart, with thanksgiving in our heart. Thank you, Lord. For everything that you have done in our lives, oh God. Oh, we thank you, we thank you. For you are good. For you are good. Oh, Jesus, Jesus, Jesus. Oh, how can I say thanks for the things you have done for me? Things so undeserved, yet you gave to prove your love for me. The voices of a million angels could not Jesus. great. Come on, sing your praises now.
Sing with me, how great is our God, and all will see how great is our God.
Jesus, oh, we are victorious, we are more than conqueror, God. Oh, we can do all things through Christ who strengthens us. Oh, we give you all the glory, oh God. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord, that you are faithful and true, Jesus, for each one of us. Oh, you've been so good to each one of us, oh God. Thank you, Lord. Oh, come on, sing to God. Oh, Jesus. How great is our God. Sing with me, how great is our God, and all will see how great is our God. Our God, how great. How great is our God. Thank you, Lord. Oh, thank you, Jesus. Shout to the Lord. Shout to the Lord for His good. Oh, thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Father, for everything that you have done in our lives. Thank you, Lord, that you have done great things, Jesus. And we give you all the glory, all the honor, and all the praise. In the mighty name of Jesus, come on, say, Amen. Hallelujah.
Was it on? how great our God is. Amen.
Y'all so serious.
Hey, look. Tita Gia's here. Hey, look. Chairman's here. Hey. Hey, look. Mom Suzette's here. Hey, look. Pastor Brent's here. Why is he here? I don't know why. Oh, God. What a good and great God we have. He is worthy of all the praise and worthy of all the glory. And every time we go ahead and try to talk about our lineups and we start asking ourselves, ano po yung mga kanta natin? You know, napaka-allergic pa rin ako dun sa how great is our God. But on the other hand, you know, it's been more than 10 years, more than 20 years that we've been singing how great is our God. But it still remains true. He is great.
through the years, through the months, through the weeks, He remains to be great and He will always be great. There are certain things that we put to remembrance whenever we sing something like that. And it never fails. Maski na sinasabi natin na parang laspag na yun yung kanta na yan. Oh my gosh, it just, you start remembering things every time you sing of the goodness and the greatness of our God. Even when cups start to fall down. Let's go ahead and pray. Father, we praise You. We thank You. We glorify You. You are worthy of all the praise, worthy of all the glory, worthy of all the honor. Truly and indeed, we sang it 10 years ago, we'll sing it today. You are great. And we want to recognize that greatness today by way of remembering Your grace. We give You all the glory, for You alone deserve it. In Jesus' name, amen. So, here's the thing. We've been singing How Great is Our God for 10 years now. And by the way, if I may bring to remembrance, I don't think it's an accident that Paolo's here. I don't think that it's an accident that Mama Suzette is here. I don't think it's an accident that the chairman is here, Tita Gia. Representatives of some of the other people groups that have been influenced by the Good News Community Church, because 10 years ago, exactly 10 years ago, around what, 2011, was when we started opening up to the gospel of grace. Did you guys realize that? And I don't know how many times we were singing How Great is Our God back then, but we were certainly starting to sing about the grace of God more than anything else. We started to learn, unlearn, and relearn so many beautiful things back in that day. And it just so happened that so many incidents happened in 2011. But did we falter? Did we fall? No. Only flourished, because that's exactly the point when we realized that even in the midst of all the turmoil, God's grace continued to shine even more. What a good and great God we have. You know, these men and women that I've mentioned here have been witness to those times that we have been almost, and you know, we've been torn apart so many times, but praise the Lord, because even up until then, I can say 10 years running, the grace of God has always kept us together, and we continue to say that He is so good to us. We give Him praise, we give Him glory. Last week, we talked about God's love. And I talked specifically about how our Lord loves us. Key word is everlasting. The Lord loved us with an everlasting love. Jeremiah chapter 31, verse 3. He proclaimed to Israel back in the day that I have loved you with an everlasting love. And I believe the same thing applies to each and every one of us, especially those of us who have had trouble trying to grasp it. Because see, when we realize that God has an everlasting love, that means that this is a love that has no end. That is for sure. We know that God's love never ends. And we know because it never ends, we know for a fact that it still continues no matter what we do, no matter what we say. But we also have to realize that because the love of God is everlasting, we also have to remember that it does not just have an end, no end, but it also does not have a beginning. So in other words, guys, here's the thing. Tayo pong mga creations. We are creations of God under the Creator who is God Himself. We must understand that because we are creations, it is our nature to have a beginning and an end. But when it comes to a Creator who does not have a beginning and an end, it is only natural for Him to say that when He loves us, His love also has no beginning and has no end. What is my point here? Guys, it can never be that the creation, it can never be that we chose to decide to love God first. But it is said in the book of Romans, chapter 5, that before and while we were yet sinners, God loved us first. And not only did He love us, but He gave us His life. He expressed His love through His life laid down for each of us. Point here being, inunahan niya po tayo. But that was the only way to save us, for Him to love us first. And when you think about it, you know, we see this love manifest whenever, like, say for example, a parent does all sorts of things in preparation para dito po sa anak niya. Like, say for example, I remember myself when I was a kid, you know, I was just wearing a Cub Scout shirt. Don't put that on video. I was wearing a Cub Scout uniform, right? And next thing that I know, sinasabi nila sa akin, I was grade 3 at the time dito po sa SPED, one of my crowning achievements. I was a Cub Scout, K-A-B, because yeah, Filipinos, you know. We were Cub Scouts, right? And all of a sudden, I just realized that someone told me, hey, Brent, Master Cub Scout ka. I'm like, Master Cub Scout? That must be really important. And the next thing I know, I'm sitting on a truck, and then we were paraded down Session. I think that was Baguio Day or something, and I was just waving my hands like, oh, I'm Master Cub Scout. I don't know how, but yeah, I have a sash, everything. I like the glitters, but yeah, hey, Master Cub Scout right here. But here's the thing. I did not know that behind the scenes, yun palang Master Cub Scout na yun, bentahan pala ng ticket yun. And my parents were primo deluxe when it comes to selling tickets. So, in other words, they were the ones who worked, but I was the one who benefited. I believe it's the same thing with our Lord Jesus Christ, but because He was the one who worked, and we, up until today, continue to benefit from that love. But it wouldn't be anything if the Lord didn't choose to love us first. He did not just have the choice, but He alone had the power to love, and He loved us first. And we continue to give Him praise for that. What a good and great God we are. Are you guys triggered? Every time I say we continue to give Him praise, you start clapping. I love it. You guys are good. Before He loved us, rather before the creation of everything, He loved us first. And you know, this isn't like a stalker kind of love, you know. It's not like I go ahead and look at somebody's profile and say, oh, I love this picture and you know, all that. No, He loved us very decently, you know. He was willing to go ahead and give everything, but of course, syempre, whosoever believes, right? I mean, it's still up to us to believe. He's out there, He's shouting on the rooftops that I love this person. But it wouldn't really mean anything until we go ahead and believe that first. Right? And that's love. Love, the love of God, the living legacy of the Lord God, and His love is seen through Jesus Christ. And when He says that He loves us forever, and when He says that He loves us with an everlasting love, and we have a hard time believing that, we can always remember to look at the example and look at the proof of the Lord Jesus Christ Himself. Now we talk about grace. We talk about Christ's living legacy of grace. And by the end of these minutes that I have speaking to you guys here today, I pray that we all have a refreshed perspective on the gospel of grace. I'm going to be talking from the Bible, and we're going to go down this road together. All right? And especially for us, Ma'am Suzette, you know, Tito Steve, Mama Gia, guys, Aces, worship team. There was a time, guys, that we weren't the Aces. There was a time that we were called Graceful. You remember that? We were called Graceful. Graceful with a double L. But I had to specify. But the thing is, you know, we've been talking about grace for the longest time. And I don't think it's an accident that you guys are here. Because 10 years after we started talking about grace, I think it's about time that we start talking about it again. Parang refresher lang po ba? Right? So let's start off with John chapter 1, verses 15 to 17. And I read, John the Baptist bore witness of them and cried out, oh, John the Baptist bore witness of Christ and cried out, saying, this is He of whom I said, He who comes after me is preferred before me, for He was before me. Again, before the creation, God was already there. Before the creation, Christ was already there. And of His fullness we have received, and grace for grace. For the law was given through Moses. But grace and truth came through Jesus Christ. Again, we go ahead and touch down on saying that God did love us with an everlasting love. How do we know this? Because Christ was before of everything else. And this is further elaborated upon in these verses that I just mentioned. And also consider this. He was before John. And before the existence of time, And of his fullness, we have received grace. And here's the thing. We did not just receive grace through our Lord Jesus Christ, but we received grace and truth. Take note about the words here, because it was the law that came through Moses, but grace and truth came through our Lord Jesus Christ. So what am I trying to say here? It could have been easily said that whoever was writing the Gospel of John right there, he could have easily said the law and truth came through Moses. But no, here's the thing. Grace and truth came through the Lord Jesus Christ. So it's all right. We need to go ahead and put into consideration the law. But the truth sticks with the Lord Jesus Christ, because grace and truth came through Jesus Christ. Amen? So that's something that we continue to go down the line here, is because we used to just think about grace as something about, like, oh yes, unmerited favor. We have the favor of God. That's the grace of God. But here we're starting to realize that we cannot separate grace from the truth of the Lord Jesus Christ. Because grace and truth, they came with the Lord Jesus Christ. Let me go ahead and read from Romans chapter 5, verse 20. Moreover, the law entered that the offense may abound. But where sin abounded, grace abounded much more, so that as sin reigned in death, even so grace might reign through righteousness to eternal life through Jesus Christ our Lord. So we see here in this verse that the law has its purpose as well. Remember, the law came through Moses. When we say that the Lord came through Moses, and when we put this together where it says here that the law entered that the offense may abound, this is to say that the law pointed out the offenses that we were already doing. Ever since the fall, ever since Adam and Eve ate that fruit in the Garden of Eden, we have experienced our offense. We have experienced being fallen. And what was the purpose of the law? According to this verse, and according coming from Moses, the law was there to point out that we were flawed. The law was there to point out that we had sin. The law was there to point out that we are fallen. Why do bad things happen, even to good people? Well, guess what? It's because we are in a fallen world. And the law is there to point out that sin is still rampant and that sin is still present. But where sin abounded, grace abounded much more. This is verse 21, by the way. So that as sin reigned in death, even so grace might reign through righteousness to eternal life through Jesus Christ our Lord. Friends, we've had so many snafus. We've had so many bad things happening right before this service. I mean, you know, brownout kanina. Tapos all sorts of other mess ups with the mic and all that. It's just like to say that the Lord doesn't want this message being shared. But here's the thing. Even in the presence of all these things that are trying to set us back, in fact, because of these things trying to set us back, mas lalo naming gusto mag-preach when it comes to the grace of God. It is even in the good times, we're going ahead and saying, oh, praise the Lord for His righteousness. But especially even in the bad times, that's where we go ahead and say even louder, oh my God, the grace and righteousness of our God is so good, and I see that because I see it in the darkness. What a good and great God we serve. Give Him praise in the house. The law was given through Moses that the offense may abound. And at the cross, at the cross where sin abounded and reigned in death, even leading to the death of the Lamb of God, behold, and this is important. What I'm trying to say here is that, yes, sin and death have their way, and they will have their way with us. But sin and death had no greater time and had no ultimate time compared to the death of our Lord Jesus Christ at the cross. You want to see the most sin happening? It was at the cross. You want to see the most death happening? It was at the cross. We're not talking about quantity here, because we know for a fact that so many people have died in history, millions and millions, over the Holocaust and so many wars and plagues and so on and so forth. That's all numbers. But guys, we're talking about the death, not just the death of one person, but we're talking about the death of one man, one God who was born a man. And the death the quality and the quantity of the death of the Lord Jesus Christ cannot be exceeded. What I'm trying to say here is that there was no greater death and there was no greater manifestation of sin than when the Lord Jesus Christ was crucified. Sin and death had done its worst to our Lord Jesus Christ. The cup was drained. He said himself that I will drain the cup down to its dregs, and I will drain sin and death down to its dregs. But behold, after 3 days, the only begotten Son of God rose from the dead, abounding much more, reigning in righteousness to eternal life. Death could not hold the ever-living God down. He had taken all the sin. He had taken all the death. It was just right. Because after he took all the sin and death, he just lived again. Guys, my point here is that Jesus Christ, when he rose from the dead, proved to everyone and all of us that sin and death was temporary. Sin and death had a beginning and the end. But Jesus Christ, once again, sure as his love is everlasting, and his love has no beginning and end, so his life has no beginning and has no end. And that life has been given to us because we have been declared righteous. That is the grace of God. That is the favor that has been bestowed upon each and every one of us, that we would be in right standing by no less than the Lord Jesus Christ, and by the Lord and before the King of all kings and the Lord of lords, we can go ahead and run to him and say, Abba, Father, come boldly to the throne of grace, the Lord God says. What a good God we serve. And let's continue down the line here. 2 Corinthians chapter 4, verse 15 says, "For all things are for your sakes, that grace, having spread through the many, may cause thanksgiving to abound to the glory of God." We continue down and see 2 Corinthians chapter 12, verse 9. You remember this, where Paul was complaining, and Paul was having some trouble with himself, and he was complaining to God to go ahead and take out his pain. But the Lord Jesus Christ himself responded by saying, "My grace is sufficient for you, for my strength is made perfect in your weakness." How did Paul respond? He responded by saying, "Therefore, most gladly, I will rather boast in my infirmities, that the power of Christ may rest upon me." Let's continue down the line here, and we go to Ephesians, the book of Ephesians, chapter 2, verses 8 and 9. "For grace you have been saved, for by grace you have been saved through faith, and that not of yourselves. It is the gift of God, not of works, lest anyone should boast." And finally, we go to 1 Peter chapter 4, verse 10. "As each one has received the gift, minister it to one another as good stewards of the manifold grace of God." Friends, I understand. I understand that I keep on telling you guys that, yes, if you want to go ahead and look at the grace of God, if you want to go ahead and receive and understand the grace of God more and more with every day, you can go ahead and look at the Lord Jesus Christ. But let us also remember the importance of the Bible. Let us remember the importance, especially of the New Testament, because we see here the perspectives of the other apostles when it comes to the grace of God. Clearly, we have seen here that grace is not only something that has been given to us, but it's something that is sufficient for us. We also see here, as Paul was writing to the Corinthians, that this grace is not just a grace that makes us feel good, but if we truly understood grace, we would understand that it causes us to just keep thanking our God. The grace of God has us thinking about God every time. We remember that by the grace of God, and it is not by our works, but it is by the grace of God that we have been saved. What am I trying to say here? Am I trying to discount or am I trying to discredit the works that we have? Maybe not. No. What I am saying is that the grace of God has us appreciating the finished work of our Lord Jesus Christ before our works. So in other words, when we understand the grace of God working in our lives through our Lord Jesus Christ and his finished work, that's when the works come out from us. We do not work in order for Christ to work for us. But grace says that because Christ worked for us, we are able to work. Amen? There was a time in my life when I realized, You know, if the world is going to end anyway, I mean, why in the world should I what's the point of my life? Why should I even care? You know, I should just go ahead and believe in the Lord Jesus Christ and just kill myself already, because, you know, I mean, there's nothing left for me to do because Jesus did it all. But I will never understand. I realize that I will never understand for myself, in my limited mind, the purpose of the Lord in this life. Which is why we go ahead and say that while we are in this life, and while we are in this messed up world and this messed up reality, the best thing for each and every one of us to do is just to go ahead and appreciate that grace that the Lord God has given to us. Because every time we appreciate grace, we are automatically, again, appreciating the finished work of our Lord Jesus Christ, which causes us to work. There was a time in my life when I thought that I wasn't going to do anything because it was all going to be meaningless. But guess what? It is the finished work of the Lord Jesus Christ that has given meaning, and therefore it is from there that we are able to work here. I talked to a friend, and we were talking about how precise, exactly like what I was saying. I was saying that, hey, you know what? If it were up to me, gusto ko nang umuwi. I just want to go home already. Sick of this life. Sick of this world. Sick of all that's going on, all the drama. I don't need this in my life anymore. You know? All I want to hear, maybe one of these days I'll just go ahead and sleep, and maybe I'll just go ahead and hear Pastor Oscar's voice saying, "Well done, my good and faithful servant. Enter thou in the..." You know? But here's the thing. And then she agreed with me also that, yes, I feel that too, Kuya. Lots of times I think about that. And then I think to myself, when we think about it that way, and when we see, and when we realize na nandito pa rin tayo sa mundong ito, when we compare na kapag wala na po tayo dito, who knows what's gonna happen in eternity? Hindi po ba? Who knows what's gonna happen? I mean, it like kayo po, ano yung mga iniisip niyo mga mangyayari sa atin when, you know, when all of this is over? Like, are we ganun po yun? May mga comics na ganun na will we have our own white clothes and playing our harps with the circles over our heads with the undersized wings in our backs, you know? Or, I mean, is it all going to be like, are we going to be talking about, "Oh, my mansion is bigger than yours. Guess what? I was doing all this in earth," and all that. No one can really know. And I think that's part of what keeps us excited about it. But until that time, guys, comparing the fact that we are going to be there for all eternity, and when you think about how fleeting our life is here on earth, mapapaisip ka na parang, wait, I am only in this life for so long. Compared to eternity with God, which is guaranteed with the Lord Jesus Christ, by His grace, I could go ahead and look at the rest of my life here and think, ngayon lang to. It's just gonna be now that I'm gonna be going through, I mean, it's just gonna be now that I'm gonna be dealing with the filth and all the fallenness and all the brokenness of this world. And when, I mean, there's never gonna be a time just as compared to this where I will never, I mean, after all this, kasi mawawala na eh. Do you guys get my point? I hope you guys are getting my point here. Kasi yung nangyayari dito is parang, in the future, wala na tong mga to eh. In eternity, wala na yung pain, no more sickness. It makes me not want pain, it doesn't make me want sickness, but it makes me think na, look, I'm only going to experience the grace of God and this pain for only a temporary moment. So even in my pain, I will appreciate the grace of God because this is not going to last forever. Even in my anxiety, I will continue to appreciate the grace of God for my life because this is just for now. And because for the rest of eternity, wala na to. So what I'm trying to say is that whether you are young or old, whether you are in the top position or the lowest of lows, let's enjoy the grace of God given to us by the Lord Jesus Christ. Let's enjoy the fact that God chose to love us first. Let's enjoy the fact that Let's enjoy the fact that God has given us life and life eternal, and we're able to live it here. That's the purpose. That's the reason why we're here. Grace gives us that reason. Grace gives us a reason to get out of bed in the morning. Grace gives us that reason to keep going out and living our life. Not necessarily just talking to people and saying, "Have you heard about the Lord Jesus Christ?" No! If we understand the grace of God, the people will go ahead and see in us, "Bakit ka nakangiti? Why are you smiling?" And I don't really even have to elaborate. Sila rin magsasabi, "Kristiyano ka, no? You believe in Jesus, don't you?" How do you know that? Because I'm celebrating the grace of God, baby. Let's give Him praise in the house. I don't know if I was able to elaborate. It's been 10 years. And, you know, it's been 10 years and it's been at least a year and it's been a couple of, maybe a month already since some of our titans in faith have fallen. But let me go ahead and just end with this. Acts chapter 20, verse 24. "I do not account my life of any value, nor as precious to myself, if only I may finish the course and the ministry that I received from the Lord Jesus to testify to the gospel of the grace of God." Sound familiar? I don't think it's an accident that Pastor Oscar went ahead and shared that before he went home. It was as if he was saying, "Let me give this to you. Now that you understand it, I'm going to go ahead." And let me also finish with this. 1 Timothy chapter 1, verses 12 to 14. "I thank Him who has given me strength, Christ Jesus our Lord, because He judged me faithful, appointing me to His service. Though formerly I was a blasphemer, persecutor, and an insolent opponent." But I received mercy because I had acted ignorantly in unbelief. And the grace of our Lord, where sin abounded, grace abounded much more. And the grace of our Lord overflowed for me with the faith and love that are in Christ Jesus. This is the gospel of the grace of God. You see before you right now someone who has been torn apart by so many things. But it's only this grace of God that brings us together. It's only the grace of God that brought me together. It's only the grace of God that kept us together as a church, whether we were torn apart 10 years ago. It was the grace of God that kept us together, even though our Pastor Oscar decided to go home to be with the Lord. It is the grace of God that shows and proves that our God is faithful and He will never let us go and He will never leave us nor forsake us. That even though we were blaspheming Him, even though we were persecuting His loved ones, and even though we were opponents to those who were champions of the faith, God continued in His grace to love us, and He continued and He never stopped loving us. Ang galing talaga ni Lord. Ang galing lang talaga ni Lord. And it's not my prayer. It's not my prayer na you have to go through life and you have to be torn apart by life before you realize how exactly good our God is. You don't need to go through that. You just need to realize right here and right now that if you want to know about the grace of God, all you need to know is that you need to look at the Lord Jesus Christ, who loved you first. And He did not just choose to love you, but loved with everything. And He is committed to love you, not just today, but forever. No matter what you are thinking, no matter what you are doing, no matter what you are up to, no matter what's holding you right now, no matter what's holding you back right now, no matter what's tearing you down right now, the Lord Jesus Christ, and no less than the Creator of the universe, chooses to love you. And that's because that is in His nature, that He loves us and He is full of grace. We say hail, full of grace, to other people, but there is no person fuller than grace of grace than our Lord God. And we give Him grace. We give Him glory. In Jesus' name, amen. Can we give Him a clap? Come on. I'm sorry you had to see that, you know. I shouldn't be crying because, I mean, the thing about it is this is something that you get so used to. Pero gaya po ng sinabi ko, hindi ka talaga magsasawa sa grace ng Panginoon eh. Hindi natin pwedeng sabihin na parang, ay, grace, alam ko na yan. Guys, it's grace where we started and it's grace where we continue. Heavenly Father, we praise and glorify Your name. Thank You, Jesus, for Your grace. Thank You for Your grace that is demonstrated by the finished work of our Lord Jesus Christ. And thank You, Lord, that wherever we are in life, we can always, always remember that it is by Your grace we are embraced by the Lord God and no less than the Creator. Thank You, Jesus, for Your love. Thank You for Your faithfulness. Thank You for Your grace continuing to manifest in our lives. Let us all see that grace with each and every day in the light and the darkness. We praise and glorify You. We thank You. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Now go ahead and receive this blessing. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make His face to shine upon you. The Lord lift His countenance upon each and every one of you and give you peace. In the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. Amen and amen and amen. Folks, for those of us who are here, let's go ahead and come on. Let's give him a clap. Moving forward, let's continue living in that grace, guys. And if you guys, kung nababad trip po kayo, ngayon lang to. Enjoy Christ. For those of you who are giving here, the box is there. For those of you guys who are giving online, we'll be posting those details shortly. We thank God for electricity. We thank God for the internet. We give Him praise today. Have a good week, guys. We love you so much. Bye-bye.
Celebrate grace. Let's celebrate Jesus. If not for Your goodness, if not